I have Radha Babu Premiappan. He is the founder and CEO of Wild Millet. I connected to him recently and he has become our sponsor in DIPL. Welcome, Radha Babu.
Thank you.
Before we get into your products, which are very interesting, and I'm very much mesmerized by seeing the variety of product that people can incorporate into their day-to-day life if they're health conscious. So we'll get into it a little bit later. But my question to you is how you are connected to cricket and why you are sponsoring the IPL.
Okay. So if you talk about cricket, every Indian origin people have their, at least, you know, the people who born in 70s and 80s have there in their blood, because they must have been played somewhere, sometime, somewhere in their ground, not necessarily to be a proper bat or ball. And in fact, in my childhood, I used to play with, the coconut tree stuff. With coconut tree, I played with the cricket, right? So that's one thing. And number two is every game in the world is actually has its own charisma, right? Cricket has its own charisma. In fact, it's kind of a mental game, not a more of a mental game than the physical game. That is why if you see most of the Indian origin games, in fact, I do support a lot of native games, especially kabaddi and a lot of native games. But when it comes to cricket, it's a mind game. You need to be concentrated, right? The first thing is how do you watch the ball? What is the direction of the ball? There are so many factors towards that. It's not just simply go and, you know, play ball, like it's not a volleyball or anything, right? So that's why it's like cricket is a mind game. We pray Manas as a god, right? That's how it's.
That's a beautiful Manas is a god. Because I never thought, but you're right, like a lot of concentration right from when the ball is leaving the baller's hand to all the way how it reaches to the batsman's bat. You have to have a very good concentration and not only just mind game from the strategy perspective or, you know, making your opponents weaker through the mind game, but mind also means, you know, having full concentration, be in the game.
Yes, it's always, you know, you need to be awake.
How long you have lived in Dallas here?
I moved here to Dallas in April 2019. So prior to that, I was in Virginia.
What brought you in Dallas? You know, is it hot weather than Virginia, better weather or something
else?
People
ask this question. When I say that, you know, what brings in Dallas brings me. That's it, right? Philosophically, from my, you know, yoga and everything, it is not that, you know, I choose the place to live. The place choose me to be living there.
Very well said. Talking in philosophical terms. So I know you are behind this product line, not purely for the commercial reason, because I saw some book and some white paper while researching a bit about you. So can you talk a little bit about your philosophy?
Thank you. Actually, the Wild Millet is born based out of for 20 people requirement. So I used to conduct, I used to conduct a yoga classes back in Virginia, back in around three and a half years back. One of the concepts within the yoga is actually the food. Because there are two things which exist in the world for the people to live. Not only people, for every creature to be living. One is air. Number two is food. If these two not exist, nothing is exist.
I go on the mountain, so I believe in Panch Tattva.
All these five, right? Water, Prithvi, Akash, air, and fire. All these fire, right? So with that saying, all this food, actually, when you eat any food, it actually translates into rasam. Rasam means it's a liquid. And then eventually into the flesh, bone marrow, and then Nada Bindu. Nadavindu means it's actually, it's, we call it as in a regular way, you know, the physical world is actually, the reproduction systems, right? So this takes about 49 days. So when you eat any food, when it comes out, the output of the after 48 days, it actually makes you what you are.
wild millet, I mean, like, I, as far as I know, I see them as a multi-grain. I see them as a different types of cereals.
Right.
Because when I was a kid, my mom, my family used to cook jowar, bajra, different types of, you know, grains. And it was so regular in the childhood. But I think coming to US, we are just eating wheat and rice. We don't move beyond that. And the concept of multigrain is new here. But how would you define millet?
Millet is nothing but small grains, which covers with multiple layers of husks. So each husk, so each millet has its own definition of husk. So one of the millet is called a kodo millet, has seven layers of husk. And some of the millets have three, mostly all the millets have minimum three husk level.
These millets are farmed by human beings on a large scale, like wheat, or they are kind of like, you know, just grow everywhere and they harvest it.
Okay, so this can be grown anywhere, first thing. It doesn't need a lot of water. It can be grown in a dry land or even in with a lot of you know, good water land as well, both places. And most of these millets are grown in natural places. You don't need any special places like, you know, for farming or any kind of things. It's easy to grow.
So connecting the dots, as far as I know, nowadays people are going for gluten-free diet.
Right.
Because some, they don't eat wheat anymore or rice anymore. But these millets sounds like they are multi-grain, different types of grains. They can be grown in any climate.
Right.
And they have extra nutrition. Some are polished, some are unpolished. That's what I learned.
Yes.
And so what is the difference between polished and unpolished?
Okay. So let me explain that, you know, okay. When it comes to the millets, right, millets are mostly minerals rich, the first thing. Most of the, in nutrient, in the standard nutrient facts, we don't put that as a requirement. That is why we don't list it. But these are all very minute and very basic things which are required for our health to be continued good health. That's one. Number two is a protein. So as I said, the millets are encapsulated by the proteins. In order to digest the millet, you need to digest the protein first before you digest the carbohydrates.
That's interesting. I mean, like, so I took one of your millets flakes or something, and before going to cricket, I'm just trying to make the connections here. Sometimes we just go by eating, you know, banana or just will have milk and go and play 4 hours. So sometimes that energy is not sufficient, but when I tried to make it and there is a recipe written on the box,
okay.
So I went by the recipe and first time I tried the flair millets and it was very interesting and my wife took it to school and gave it to a bunch of other teachers.
Okay.
So everyone liked it. So this is first time I tried it. And with Indian spices and everything, it was very nice breakfast for me.
Okay. The flakes which you are talking about, it's called Mapale Samba, right? So when it comes to the category, Samba is one type of rice, in a native rices, out of which Mapale Samba, Mapale means it's a groom, right? So this rice is specially made for the grooms, meaning that in the young age, they need a lot of energy, right? In order to have more energy, the Mapale Samba is a good one, right? So again, and when it comes to the foxtail, if you need a lot of protein, you can use this one, right? And then if you need iron, you can use the red sorghum. If you need you know, diabetes-related things, you can use the finger.
And I also see jaggery because people are used to white sugar,
yes,
versus, you know, this is kind of a brown sugar or made from sugarcane or
no,
palm.
It's a palm. There are
palm.
Two things we have.
Yeah.
One is... this is sugar cane, pure sugar cane. And this palm jaggery, it's purely made out of palm.
The less processed it is, this is what I learned, is good. So I'm overall impressed. I mean, like, and then you have some natural oil, cinnamon oil.
Yes, it's all cold pressed oils.
Uh-huh.
So these cold pressed oils are mainly used for, if you take sesame oil, the sesame oil is pretty much used for... bone-related things, right? Bone strengthening. And the peanut oil, it's mainly used for the flavoring. right? So these are all, actually speaking, these are all natural preservatives. If you make in a right way through these oils, that won't get spoiled. That's how these oils were actually built. And the coconut oil is the one which basically we used it for mainly for the skin. And this one is a copra. So what we get here is all, virgin oil. Virgin oil means they take the extract, coconut milk extract, and they produce it. But this one is a purely sun-dried coconut oil.
Yeah. Nowadays, health products are more expensive, and it's getting day-to-day. If you want to eat junk food, burger, something, you can get $1, $2.
Yes.
But if you want to eat healthy food, it's getting very expensive. So seems like you're having some philosophical based, some health based.
Yes.
It's one of the biggest value in human being in our own life, you know, to be responsible for our health. And I'm very impressed that you're bringing these products from India to here.
Yes.
And trying to distribute to the community for a good cause.
Yes, of course. Thank you. And in fact, you know, I really appreciate you, you know, people like you also in this context, because nowadays the healthy products are becoming more expensive. It's not supposed to be actually, because not many people are supporting these kind of products. So the more we, you know, supply the quantities, eventually these prices will go down, and then everybody gets, you know, better products all the time.
I hope our cricketing audience try these products and take control of their health, eat healthy food.
Yes.
And natural food, unprocessed food.
Yes, it's all unprocessed and all natural products. No pesticide, no chemicals added. Everything is natural.
Awesome. Thank you so much. And welcome again once more. Greetings for being our sponsor in DIPL.
Thank you. And thanks for having me here. And appreciate all your time and efforts to have this, you know, making this available for people.
We wish you great success.
Thank you so much. Apni ye karm bhoomi hai yahi, apni ye daasta. Keh ke na kabhi karke rakhni hai baat apni yahan. DIPL. Yeah, DIPL, League of the Leaf, yeah, best DIPL.